and welcome to Boss's Day Out. My boss on the show today believes in one simple word, change. The only way to survive in this dynamic world is to change. A billionaire when it comes to net worth, a first entrepreneur, rich azar when it comes to the telecom accessory market, a great human being, believes in hospitality and great hospitality for his guest, and is a go-getter when it comes to his personal mission. Manoj Tirodkar, the chairman of Global Group. Let's welcome him on this edition of Boss's Day Out. Good morning, Mr. Tirodkar.
Good morning.
So nice to have you on NDTV. Thank you for accommodating this interview request.
Thank you. My pleasure.
It's 7 in the morning and I've been told that you believe in a simple philosophy. Early to bed, early to rise.
Yes, indeed. It's been a very old habit for me from my childhood, basically, to wake up very early, 4:35, and then start my day. Mm-hmm. And that's what it's all about. Mm-hmm.
So what's on the agenda for the day, Mr. Tirodkar?
Start the day with a cup of tea. I mean, before I just get down to work, let's just sit down and have a cup of tea and chat up about the day.
Certainly.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about yourself, the non-work side of Manoj Tirodkar.
Well, essentially the non-work side is my interest in travel, across music, across architecture. For me, from the time I have started work or otherwise, again coming back to work, I live, breathe or otherwise, practice on a daily basis everything that happens around in the telecom industry.
That somehow seems to be the focus area for you. I mean, from your career, telecommunication, connectivity, networking, that thing I think in your career you've always focused on.
Yeah, I think, Nikunj, the basic of this goes back all the way to 1976 or 77, when I was hardly about 13 or 14 years old. And when I went for the first time to Singapore and I saw a fax machine that sort of sent a document from one end and the document came out from the other, and it fascinated me.
So what is sense of achievement? Sense of achievement is starting a business, running a business, or simply generating wealth out of it?
I think there are many things to it, and the sense of achievement in that sense is sense of excelling.
It's not about making money always?
I don't think so. It never was, and it never is for somebody like me. I think it's a byproduct. It's an important byproduct by which you sort of measure yourself.
Life is convenient if you have more money.
Well, let's put it this way. There is a lot you can do with it. For example, in our case, we are using the power of the money that we have in many ways on things like our CSR program, the foundation that we have set up for GTL Foundation.
You pretty much have set the agenda for the day now. Now let's move to the other side. So where are we off to now?
I think we are off to our BPC, our business planning conference.
Which is essentially the annual conference you do.
Yes, that's where we basically give a message about what we want to do. All our managers gather there, more than 170 people today. So big day for us.
Okay, let's go, sir. Okay.
My job today is to, set some tough targets internally to our people and to share the vision of where we want to take our company over the next few years.
this is a typical site, just to make it simple, which essentially is the backbone for connecting mobile phones.
Yes, I mean, when you use your mobile phone and you move in from one end to another, you are actually communicating with what you see on the top, from where the signal is laying down. And I think we'll sort of explain to you and show you.
It's a radio antenna. It's as simple as that.
Yes, there is a lot of things there besides radio antenna. There are some microwave radios and there's a whole connectivity gamut there. And I think I'll take you there. And you know, I have some of my colleagues who will take you through what we really have here. Meet Bharat. Bharat. This is Bharat. Bharat is our head of operations. This is Nikunj from NDTV. Bharat is in charge of all that goes on throughout the country in terms of management, engineering, and you know, everything of the site.
This is the site where we are built it for most. Now we have got about 6 operators here. They are MTNL, we have got Tata, we have got BPL, we have got Vodafone, we have got Bharti. So these are the leading operators who are sharing this particular tower of ours here. This is a very unique place where all the operators are in a position to provide the kind of a coverage for all their customers.
This was also a unique initiative of MOST,
yes,
right? Which was commenced by would you like to
explain? Service.
Okay.
There was an initiative of the government of India to get most of the service operators to come together and to share a platform. So this was one of the first towers put together, and
it's special one for
it's unique because when 6 operators share it, it eventually means that basically the cost, as I told you, of operation, maintenance, and energy is dramatically cut.
Tell us how large the group has become now, purely in terms of the listed one and the non-listed ones now.
See, the holding company is called Global Asset Holding Company, and that's what the global stands for, and endless possibilities. Mm-hmm. And we have 2 listed companies, GTL, which was earlier known as Global Telesystems Limited, which was abbreviated because it was no longer a telecoms company then. Global Towers, which is a manufacturing company that manufactures towers. Global Enosource, that provides quality manpower. Global ProServ, that's basically our IT component that's hived off, and Global Projects, that does global procurement, and GTL Infrastructure. So we have effectively 6 companies, out of which 2 are listed.
You also mentioned we would be talking to some of your M&A, your top M&A team.
Yes.
That's been the focus area for you, hasn't it?
Yes, it's very much the focus of our growth, because we think that GTL, for example, is in network planning, network design, network infrastructure provisioning, operation and maintenance, professional services on the engineering side, infrastructure management. I think a lot of what we do is now dictated by our global ambition to be the world's largest network services provider. So yes, we are focused on M&A as an important tool to attend that growth.
So that's where we're headed now.
Yes, we are just going to meet the team.
Manoj has entered into a closed-door meeting with his top M&A team. As a group, it's the hunger perhaps, or the increased appetite to focus on inorganic growth perhaps, which is keeping the M&A team going. I've been told that they are silently working on a large deal which will have very strong implications on the entire tower industry. That's the only detail I've managed to gather as far as sniffing and smelling of news is concerned. The other feature, and which perhaps talks about the man, is the way he's named all his conference rooms / meeting rooms. He's calling them cars. Mercedes, BMW, Volkswagen. Cars have a speed, and the man for sure has a speed, and both of them move up when they have a road or perhaps a journey to travel.
But I'd like to take you to one of the important parts of our initiatives that we do as a part of the global CSR, corporate social responsibility. we won several awards, but more importantly, mm-hmm. one issue closer to my heart is the support that system that we are in the mm-hmm. process of creating for mm-hmm. a series of NGOs and children organizations. So one such project that I want to take you through.
Mm-hmm. Sure, sure, sure. Let's see. An overview.
This is Mr. Shashadri, one of the trustees of our foundation. And these are part of his team members who are positrons who also work on several initiatives we had in CSR.